cashed up, undoubtedly.
Baby gon' touch the bucks, my salary double. Your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble, I get the tackle and the pick and I hustle. I had to have it, had to get in the huddle, in the gravel and rubble.
Got me a second, I'm trying to be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle.
See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun, come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he coming a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the locker. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
Animosity resides inside of me, so I'm like a product of power.
Who in that touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Okay. Who in that touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Okay.
Coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State in TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. A few minutes prior to us coming on air, this crowd was jolted into action with the introduction of these Jaguars. They're set for football as the Jags are ready to match up with the Tennessee Titans. Quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week five. Audie looking into the raindrops, and he muffs it. Fake it. Now Tannehill. Man open here is Jones. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That goes for a gain of 31. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now a play fake, and it's Tannehill. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. They'll fake the handoff. Now Tannehill. And it's caught. Touchdown. Jeff Swaim. His first touchdown on the year. And the Titans take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Looking sharp on that first drive. These guys, of course, coming off back-to-back victories. And you see that kind of advancing into this game, don't you?
You certainly do. And when you have a team that doesn't get too full of itself, even though they've won two games in a row, you get the end result that we saw there. That nice opening drive, because they're sharp, they're focused, and they're locked into everything that they're doing.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Lawrence on first down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. They'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down. They'll run for the first time with Travis Etienne. And he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down. An ideal start defensively. They already have the touchdown. Now they get the stop.
Just like they drew it up on the chalkboard. Does that sound dated? Right? Am I out of touch a little bit?
It's all right.
All right, grease board, heck, computer, exactly what you want, though. Score on your first drive, stop them on the first drive defensively.
They're going on fourth down. Lawrence. Open man is Jacob Hollister. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. They'll run on first down. It's Robinson. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Yikes, a 4-yard loss really sets him back now for second down. Now Lawrence to throw. They'll try and set up the screen to Etienne. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down. Well, this defense for the Titans, they really played well a week ago in that win over the Jets.
And one of the key things you always look for when you're evaluating a defense is how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get per game? And how about last week's game? That number, 6. Absolutely phenomenal performance. They were on top of their game right from the first snap.
Completing it here to Marvin Jones. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
Meanwhile, Lawrence's throw here into the hands of Jones. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Here's Lawrence. They're trying to find Chark, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Dane Cruikshank. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. We thought this defense would be opportunistic, and they were. Here, you're already up. Now you got a 2-touchdown lead. I tell you, going out there on defense, did they have a little bit of extra momentum with a score already on the board?
Oh, without a doubt. That already felt good to them, and they took it and used it and obviously put up another one. But here's the thing now. Some defense coordinators might want to pull their guys back a little bit because they don't want them to make mistakes because they're too overamped. Others say, I've got 2-touchdown lead. Go get them, guys. They'll be even more aggressive.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help them a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early.
to let him get settled back in.
They told us they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
He takes us from the 30 to the 34.
So our two teams, the Jags and the Titans, CD, they've formed a pretty good rivalry here in the AFC South. It's been the Titans who have arguably, though, been the best team in the division of late. But these Jags, they have certainly made some big changes since these two teams last met.
And those changes you're talking about, brand new front office, brand new head coach, young quarterback, I think for sure they're on the right track. And to me, this division has a chance of being one of the more competitive ones over the next few years. There's no team right now that you would say is going to dominate in the foreseeable future.
On first down, Lawrence. And that's complete. ETN out of the backfield. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down. Looking to throw, Lawrence. He'll drop this one off with ETN. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Rookie quarterback, rookie running back. They team up there to pick up the first. Lawrence going to throw again. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Here's second and 10. Lawrence. And this is incomplete.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're saying.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Again, it's Lawrence. He'll let this go for the end zone. And oh no, it's incomplete. Well, it's a touchdown if he holds on, but somehow took his eyes off of it, falls to the ground, and brings up fourth down.
Matthew Wright on for the field goal. A 60-yard attempt.
Good job.
Well, they tried the field goal from just inside of 70 yards. It missed, and now this offense set up nicely at midfield. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Kalavon Chaisson able to get in there and run him down for what's going to be a loss of 15 yards all told. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town at second and a country mile. Looking deep for Julio. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he will finally be taken out of bounds. Charles, did I just hear that right? They declined the personal foul. 3 yards, they just declined them.
And I have to think that the official is thinking to himself, did I just hear that correctly, that you declined that one? All I can think of is a...
Open man, Julio. Touchdown, Tennessee. Julio Jones. with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. Now Bullock to add the extra point. So he missed his first two, but this time it's good, and that'll extend the lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Here's Chris Claybrooks to return. Oh, a good return up past the 30. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
Touchdown, Jaguars! Jacob Hollister, his first touchdown on the year. And the Jaguars are able to strike quickly for 6. Well, for a tight end, he can definitely motor, and he shows off the wheels there after the catch as he's able to shake free.
Yeah, normally when you talk about tight ends, you immediately begin talking about them rumbling down the field, but to me, he was pretty well gliding downfield there. Very athletic for a big man, and he takes this one all the way to pay dirt.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him, because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
Second and 10. Play action. It's Tannehill. Under pressure, and he's going to go down. Tannehill sacked. Now Charles dealing with a third and long. They'll have to try to go back to the air again and this time avoid the sack.
Certainly hard to try to establish momentum when all you're doing is going backwards, not protecting the passer, and he gets dumped on his backside.
So third and long after the sack. Tough task for Tannehill and the Titans. They'll get this to the rookie from Florida. That's Kadarius Toney. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That was no third and 2. That was third and 16, but they get the conversion anyway. Off play action, Tannehill. And the Jags get to him as down he goes. So, Charles, no turnovers yet for this offense, but those sacks now, they're starting to pile up.
And one thing usually leads to another, because they've got to figure out how the offensive line and everyone else involved in protection can keep their quarterback upright and allow him a chance to throw the ball downfield.
Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
Another try after the first down sack. Tannehill. Left side completion to Jones. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. 25 yards there on the catch and run. So in Jacksonville territory now. Here's a first and 10 at the 38. Tannehill. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. Going deep for Diggs. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions. Have them looking at third and 10. Back to throw, Tannehill. Man open, it's Tony. He's got it. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Kadarius Tony, his second touchdown on the season. And the Titans are able to extend their lead. And oh. Can you believe it? He misses another one, his third so far. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Clay Brooks to return it. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here, and what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Get their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Looking to throw again on second down. Lawrence. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
They head to the line facing a third and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Now Lawrence. And connecting here with DJ Chark. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
He's got a man complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 36 yards on the play. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byard. There he goes, left side. The 30. 10.
They're not even trying to do anything.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Let's keep going. It's all right.
That pick six extending this lead even further. And boy, it's been a while since I've seen a team struggle this badly in the first half.
I think all they want to do is get to the locker room, try and regroup, and come out to start the third quarter. But if things don't improve fast then, I think the backups get a lot of play in the second half.
The point after through the raindrops, up and good. And that will bump the lead up to 26.
Both these teams getting a chance to dry out, maybe change their cleats if need be. But halftime's just about over. Time to get back to it. And for the call of the second half, here's Brandon Gaudin.
All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Pass calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive, and they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster of a first half, so where do they go from here?
Well, first thing they have to remember.
The pressure gets to Lawrence, and he'll go down. The sack by Harold Landry, the former Boston College Eagle.
But when you see a quarterback retreating away from the line of scrimmage toward the other goal line like that, usually doesn't end well.
You're exactly right about that. Normally, if they're moving from side to side, they've got a chance maybe to get back upfield. He was trying to shake defenders and extend the play, but it doesn't work out very well for them at all. You need those extra yards on the other side of the line of scrimmage. Now you're digging a hole for your offense.
Pilot, 64, weak. Hey, Alpha.
On third and one, it's Lawrence. He's going to go for a big play downfield. Oh, had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Hey, exit. Four, four.
Fourth down, here's Lawrence. And he'll be touched out here, but not before he does pick up the first. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
I remember in pregame when we were talking to him on the field and he took his gloves off and showed us his fingers. A few misshapen ones in there, and now we know why, trying to catch those types of bullets.
That was a dart. Yeah, even for a talented receiver, those are tough to hang on to.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now Lawrence. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. It's picked up by the Titans. And now a fumble. The ball's out. The ball comes out, and that might be Titan football. It is.
All these years we've been watching the game, I start to get the sense that whenever it rains out, those guys have to touch the ball and carry it. They're extremely resentful about that weather.
Yeah, I'm just happy I'm not resentful that we have a roof over our heads. I know that much.
Yeah, maybe we won't fumble our play sheets here as we just saw the fumble happen on the field.
Following the fumble recovery, Tannehill. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
Yeah, the Titans are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one.
Tannehill dancing to his left, and this is caught, touchdown. Wait, hold a second here, a flag down. Let's see if this will stand. Here's Bullock now for the extra point. And this part of the game's been an adventure thus far, but this one is good. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. They'll throw on first down with Lawrence. Escaping the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. That's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Here's Lawrence to throw. He'll find ETN out of the backfield. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
55 is my guy, 55. Got 61, match box,
play. They go play action now. Lawrence steps away. Now he'll square up and throw deep left sideline. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. Give him 32 on the play. On first and 10, it's ETN. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself. And get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Second and 7.
60 yards. Mike 54. Hey, watch that. Hey, watch the ball. Mike 54. Mike 54.
Now Lawrence to throw. He'll get this out to the flat for ETN. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Play action. It's Lawrence. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Danico Autry picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
And keep in mind, in addition to the two sacks that he now has, CD, he's also had a couple of quarterback hurries. He's been very disruptive.
To put it mildly, and it reminds me of the time I asked an offensive tackle who struggled like this in a game. He said he was telling the coach, hey, what do you want me to do? This guy's just eating me alive. And the coach finally just looked at him and said, applaud.
To try again after the sack, Lawrence. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide, because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the third row.
Hey, Charlie!
On third down, Lawrence. Touchdown! A 14-yard touchdown. And the Jaguars get a score closer.
Obviously, the scoreboard right now is not the friend of this rookie quarterback, but hey, a touchdown pass there maybe builds a little confidence.
Every rep is valuable when you're a rookie. Every time you step up and throw the football, there's a lesson to be learned. Yeah, he took advantage of a little bit of loose coverage there with the lead, but at the same time, got it done. It'll take a little bit of satisfaction away from that throw.
And he's got it for the two-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further. I guess the last score wasn't enough for them. They want more. Here comes an onside kick. And the Titans are going to recover the football. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that, just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't
all
you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 23 yards the pickup there.
So first and 10. And if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Tannehill's throw caught by Tony.
And it's a Titans touchdown.
Kadarius Tony.
His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And this Titan offense is running away with this one. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty. Second and 6, just inside the 30.
Looking to throw, Lawrence.
And he slings one that's incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Lawrence will throw.
And Shark hauls it in. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Lawrence going to throw again. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
3rd and 5.
Lawrence. He'll get this off to ETN.
And they stop him up short of the first down as they get him at about the 43. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball, because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
That's caught by Hollister.
And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. And to throw again is Lawrence. And his throw is going to be incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And, boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
He'll drop this one off with ETN. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Hey, Orbit.
And they'll try and throw for it with Lawrence. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And incomplete on the deep ball. The Jags come up empty on fourth down. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example. And now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
Yeah, if you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, you're hugging him, give him a little dap. Been a big, big performance for them. Now you just don't get careless. Take care of the ball on the way out.
Tannehill on first down. And his throw is incomplete. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
He's going to sling this deep downfield. And, oh, that would get a wide up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone. Probably should have been. Third down coming up. Play action. It's Tannehill. The throw for Tony is intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they didn't get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
And the Jags are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. And they turn the pick six into a pick eight with that two-point conversion.
I love how you upsell. That is outstanding right there. What a big-time play. Big switch in how this game was going. And then they capitalize a little bit on top. And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. We're still throwing the football here. Obviously, the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work.
And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Well, he's been doing this for a lot of years with the arm strength still there, and he showed it off on that one. Tannehill looking to throw. Steps away to his left.
I know we could sit up here and dance around it a little bit, but going for two in this situation, somebody doesn't like someone else. There's no doubt in my mind.
Well, what they couldn't see is you lean back in your chair and you went,
I mean,
yeah, that's That's not a good decision. He didn't get it, though.
Yeah, I don't think he just said, well, my kicker's hurt in this spot.
No.
Okay.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I've got the wild bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
Well, had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going.
He'll definitely say that that's one he should have held on to. But when you're playing in elements like this, sometimes those bullet passes, those ones with a little bit of pace on them, they can be difficult to hold on to.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. The Jags come up empty on fourth down. And the Titans, they've got the football back, and they've got it. They'll fake it. Now Tannehill. He's got the hookup with Diggs. Touchdown! Stephon Diggs. 36 yards. And the Titans are about to make it four straight as they add to this fourth quarter advantage.
I'm not sure what other ground there is to cover here. I mean, this offense has been amazing. Just total domination, Charles.
They've clicked so well. And if you really focus in on the offensive line, they've protected well when they wanted to throw the
ball. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Well, I have to admit, I'm scratching my head a little bit here trying to make sense of what I just saw. Number one, huge lead. Just kick the extra point and be done with it. Number two, if you are going to go for two, just line up and go for it from the two-yard line. Why make it so difficult? That's a long way to go to try and pick up some points.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And this offense, last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
5 yards remain on second down.
Here's Lawrence. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A gain there of 21 yards.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
He'll take a shot for the end zone, and this one is incomplete.
Similar to a shooter in basketball who just connected on the previous shot, they run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They try to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
To throw again on second down, Lawrence. And this one into the hands of DJ Shark. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 19. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That's once again complete to Chark. And his defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. Again, it's Lawrence.
And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late. But he does get in for six.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. So now another two-point conversion attempt coming up for the Jaguars. That touchdown, Charles, the first rushing TD of his rookie year.
I don't know that he's going to be Lamar Jackson or Russell Wilson or Josh Allen at this stage of his career. But he's got youth on his side. Those young legs, he put them to good use there, didn't he?
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And it would seem as if their three-game winning streak is about to go to four, but still a little work to do as they start first and 10. A good start to the drive here as that's caught out on the left side. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. On first down, it's Tannehill. Man open here is Jones. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. And they get 17 more on that one and another first down. On first down, Tannehill. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. Under pressure, and he's going to go down. Tannehill sacked. Josh Allen. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six. So third and long after the sack. Tough task for Tannehill and the Titans. Now a play fake, and it's Tannehill. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. That was no third and two. That was third and 16, but they get the conversion anyway. Tannehill going to throw it. Eluded. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. K'Lavon Chaisson able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Brandon, that's just football 101. If you're out of the pocket, you've got to get rid of the football in this situation. You cannot take a sack in a two-minute drill.
Throwing on second and long. Tannehill sliding out of the pocket. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And that is incomplete. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
He's going to try and go deep again. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Bullock good on the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Short kick. One of the up middle take it now. And they're going to be set up with excellent field position past the 45.
Even after that big time return, it's not looking great for them today. But if nothing else, even if the miracle doesn't happen, they can turn to this play and say, hey, we can move forward. Maybe it's a building block for the rest of the season.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And that nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Oh, fortunate to retain possession there, and it's second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Lawrence to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that nearly intercepted.
It's incomplete. Now, remember, he had a pick earlier, but couldn't reel that one in.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10.
Now Lawrence. He'll get that underneath ETN.
And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. Now a timeout called for by the offense, as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ballgame. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears try to go for it on 4th. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. A desperation heave for the end zone. And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one at the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big.
He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
Here we go now as they will again try for 2. They'll let Robinson try and run. And he is not going to get to the goal line. And for the first time here this afternoon, they are thwarted on the 2-point conversion.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Titans offense set to begin the drive. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now, to put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Tennessee, they boost their record up to a strong 4-1. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Buffalo Bills. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, they drop below 500 to 2-3 with a loss. And they will be at home next week to take on the Miami Dolphins.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot, I had the answer, then forgot I knew one day my pop, finance, finite, mana, mana, flex, and I fell out and cut the check, mana, mana, palace, the set, but I've been taking hits like I can't die like any. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it, the neck of the serpent, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in the Lancer. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my guts. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, kicking the door when I come at the cut. Whoa. Yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, do what I do and I say what I want. Whoa. Yeah, mama, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who trying to battle me, huh? Hitters is after me. Can I be dabbing? Who wanna fuck me up? Fatality, really, it's up. It's up, undoubtedly. Baby, gon' touch the bucks. My salary double. Your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble. I get the tackle and the pick and I hustle. I had to have it, had to get in the huddle. In the gravel and rubble. Got me a second. I'm trying to be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle. See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun, come with the options. Send big blitz. Nobody blocking big win, that's a ring and a watch. Scrawling in when he come in a slot, trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
Thought I heard somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the locker. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
Animosity was out inside of me, so I'm like a product of Broadway.
Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut.
Okay.
Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut.
Help me now. used to burn CDs and pass them around. I used to email the venues and ask them if I could be opening act for the rappers that's passing through town. I used to be the one kids in my city was laughing about. I used to envision everything happening now. I used to ride the bus and listen to Kendrick Lamar. He just liked a video that I made back when I started to study his bars. I'd like to think that he probably related to someone that's come so far. To someone that wanted it badly, then when it got it and turned to a star. Overly dedicated, a title that resonated. I want to be recognized, I want to be decorated. Truthfully, back then I couldn't imagine a life where I never made it. Go ahead and let him hate it.
Nobody helped when I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball. Man, like every day. For all the time nobody helped me, said I ball on you. Man, like every day. For all the time you dated, man, I ball. Man, like every day. Until the day I pass away.
Salute when you see me. put in the car to my runner gets you speedy. Still thugging like the daddy.
Just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Philadelphia Eagles. First quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports. Taken in at the 3. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Play action. Here's Hurts. That's swung out wide to Sanders. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A good start offensively. 15 yards on the game's initial play.
Defensively, they came into the game with the understanding they're going to have to slow him down on passes just like this because he was over 100 yards receiving a week ago. And you know they want to get him involved here as well.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. That'll be caught. It's Rager. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. These defenses have become so opportunistic. And no matter what you're playing, in this case, wide receiver, you got to be careful.
Certainly do, because there is a phrase in today's football that we use all the time. Completing the process of the catch. Well, it's after you do that where the trouble begins, right? Meaning you've tucked it away, you're trying to get downfield, but someone's always coming up trying to rake in the ball and knock it free.
First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
From the 35 on second down, Darnold. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Here's Darnold. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 11 yards in the Panther first down. And CD, defensively, you're going against a hot quarterback coming off a 3-touchdown game in their victory a week ago. But what's the big key for them to try to slow him down?
You ask all the tough questions, don't you, partner? Because when this guy can blitz him, he takes advantage of that man coverage and burns you. But if you bring on those extra DBs, he sits back there and does what he wants. To me, it's going to be those DBs. When they catch the ball, big-time tackles really put it on those receivers.
And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
And they didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, They want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
We got three. We got three, fellas. We got three.
From the 36, Darnold.
He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey.
And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. They run with McCaffrey off the option. He's able to get 6, a nice pickup down to the 21. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
On second down at 4, Darnold. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. A little too much extracurricular there.
When you have a game with a lot of contact, tensions are going to run pretty high. You're going to be emotional, but you have to harness it somehow. And he didn't on that play.
Touchdown, Panthers. Tommy Tremble, his second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive, and they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Flush to his right. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were very good in the win over Dallas a week ago.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
A good pickup there, 26 yards. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right, and he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were very good in the win over Dallas a week ago.
But we certainly had a nice conversation with the defensive coordinator, didn't we? And what we heard, I like what we did, but we definitely need more pressure on the quarterback this week.
Hurts gets this to Sanders, and they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. They'll try and run for it with Sanders. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the eight. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts out to his left. And Goddard's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Dallas Goedert, his second touchdown on the season. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying this thing up.
This is why a lot of play callers love play action in this spot. You just want to freeze the linebackers just for a second. Then you've got a chance to get a quick pass into your tight end right behind them for a touchdown.
So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense, and Darnold, he lost the football. And the Eagles have recovered. The defense, they were swarming that time and ultimately got to him before he could get rid of the football and knocked it free.
And don't you feel just a little bit of sympathy for him back there, though? So much going on, so much swirling around. He's trying to find someone downfield. He's trying to move around to find an open target. Sometimes you forget the number one thing, take care of the football.
Rolling to his left. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Greg Ward, his first touchdown on the year. And the Eagles have taken the lead. But what a quick turnaround there. They get the football. Next play, boom, touchdown.
I've been in a situation before where a turnover occurs. If you're over on the bench with your defensive mate and you're talking about what to do on your next series, and all of a sudden you hear sudden change, you've got to get out on the field and defend right away. Not everyone is mentally prepared to go.
Is that what is yelled on the sidelines a lot of times?
That, among other things.
Maybe some words we can't share here.
Yeah, we'll just keep this one PG.
FCC violation.
No doubt.
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about it.
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A gain of 32 that time. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Now Darnold. He's going to look deep for more. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
On second down, McCaffrey. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
And incomplete on the deep ball.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. 31 yards on the punt there. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Now their last two drives, both ending in touchdowns. It's gotten them this 14-7 lead.
And it looks to me, and I think you're probably seeing the exact same thing, they're in an ideal spot now to create some separation. The way that they're functioning on offense now, they can create a pretty good gap, allows their defense to play with a little more verve and confidence.
That big article in the paper this morning about them stringing possessions together for consecutive touchdowns. Well, right here, they're trying to make it three in a row. He'll fire deep for Rager. And got his man complete. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Jalen Hurts, not a terribly big fella at 6'1", but his arm's got plenty of life to it. And that was a thing of beauty there.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it, here in the stadium, you could just sense the crowd thinking, oh, no. And their worst fears were realized as that one turned into a long touchdown.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick, and he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. That was just one of those interceptions from our perspective here. We got a good view at the 50-yard line mid-level that quarterback and receiver were not on the same page.
Just by his reaction, I'm talking about the quarterback, he expected something different from his receiver, whether he expected him to break in, out, deeper, shorter. They'll determine that on the sideline. But bottom line, you could see that he thought he'd be in a different spot, except the defender was not his intended target.
On second down, it's Sanders down to the 30 after a gain of 3.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
From the gun, it's Hurts. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Jeremy Chin picks it off, and he'll bring this one back to the 29. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Open man left side. It's the tight end Trimble. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
The Carolina Panthers picked up Tommy Trimble in the third round from Notre Dame. This is a tight end with terrific upside. A tremendous blocker. Now showing good hands on that catch for a first down.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown. Tommy Trimble with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Panthers strike quickly here for 6 points.
If you didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now, you can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
He'll get this to Ward. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position, because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Flushed out right. He'll have a first down past the 40 and all the way up to the 46. Hurts dangerous when he runs that football. He's got a first.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, his first carry of the game right there. He had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well.
And this one nearly picked off. Yeah, kind of surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but get away it does, and it's second down.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Off the play fake. Here's Hurts.
Eluding the pressure right. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And finally taken down at the 34.
That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL.
Now left side on the swing pass. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing 3 there. Second down. Hurts sets up to throw it.
Looking to get it to Ward. Intercepted.
It's C.J. Henderson picking it off.
And he will take this all the way up past the 40-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a 2-for-1 without ever even giving up the football.
Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41.
A shotgun snap for Darnold. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory.
Christian McCaffrey, the complete package. He's got the power, the hands, the agility, and he certainly also has the speed, as evidenced there. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. A fake to McCaffrey. Now Darnold. And it'll be caught in the end zone for the Carolina touchdown by DJ Moore. DJ Moore, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and we are tied here in the second quarter. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee, and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Offense sent to begin their next drive, and they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. Being chased, and he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. Jeremy Chinn able to get him down behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of a yard. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tied ball game here heading to break. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
With both of these offenses having their way, it's not likely they'll need to be doing a whole lot at halftime. But the defenses are definitely in need of some adjusting. And for the call of the second half, let's go back out to Brandon and Charles.
Yeah, Coach, certainly no shortage of action in those first two quarters. Definitely got to work on my touchdown calls, so we'll see how much voice I have left for the second half here. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Now it's Darnold. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Steven Nelson. So an opening drive interception to begin this second half.
And just think about the time you spent in the locker room going over what you expected to do in the second half. Not the way they saw it, not the way they drew it up. You find out this is something that you can't just edit, right? There's no rewrite here. This is live, and now they've got to find a way out of this hole.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Jalen Hurts taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Eagles take advantage of good field position on the turnover to cash this one in. Elliott Good on the extra point, and they will take a 7-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They'll try to get the running game going with McCaffrey. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Athleticism on display there by Derek Barnett to come up and get him. Faking the give, Darnold. Now he's flushed out right. There's Trimble, the tight end. And they're able to get this one across the 35. He's been big. Two touchdowns earlier. Now he's got a first down here. Darnold will hand off to McCaffrey. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime Mings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down. Off of play action, Darnold. Looking deep downfield. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. So Sam Darnold, not really known for having the strongest arm in the NFL, but he certainly laid that one out there. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and that will tie our game here in the third. So right back to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And some room to run now. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
48 yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball 4 times.
Defense really kept him in check running the football in the first half. Maybe that'll be a spark for him here in half two.
So 2 words come to mind for me. Resilient, because he has to keep bouncing back after some limiting runs. And how about relentless? Keep going, knowing that you may pop one, as he just did there.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. The free safety roaming all the way up to the line of scrimmage to make that stop.
How about his ability to trust his eyes and figure out it was not a pass play and go fast towards the line of scrimmage in order to make that tackle?
Hurts fumbles it. And this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well.
Can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. On third down, they turn to Sanders. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
The kick by Elliott is good. And that will break our tie and give them a 3-point lead.
So give them 3 on that drive. You know, normally you'd say, we'll take it. But the way points have been flying around, it feels like a little bit of a letdown.
Yeah, you just have to wonder, are field goals going to be enough? Because as you pointed out, the way touchdowns have been scored, does kicking a field goal actually put you at a disadvantage the rest of the way?
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Shotgun handoff down to McCaffrey. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And a solid run down inside the 30. So they get half of what they needed. It'll be third and 6 upcoming.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And he'll go down at the 28. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage, because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
And this one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
And we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest of this fourth quarter.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Throwing again on second and 10. Hurts. It's caught by Sanders. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Called in over the middle by Rager.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. He will find Smith in the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Devontae Smith, his second touchdown on the season. And the Eagles have moved out in front.
So still time remaining here in this fourth quarter, but the touchdown there puts him back out in front.
And you and I both know that their defense will not very subtly remind everyone that they started all this because they held firm on the last drive and only gave up a field goal. Gave it back to the offense in a tied game and said, okay, your turn now. Make something happen. And they went down the field and scored.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up.
They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Second down and right back to McCaffrey.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Flush to his right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And Darnold got to be intercepted for the third time. Picked up by Anthony Harris.
He exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
And Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision can get skewed just a bit. Now, the beauty of extending a play is sometimes your receivers find their way open, but oftentimes you end up closing down part of the field and bringing those defenders to the ball, and that one was picked off.
And he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Play action. Here's Hurts. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. The corner, Stephon Gilmore, on the stop.
You don't see that a ton, do you? A cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
Hurts. That'll be caught. Rager with it. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th. The Eagles send out their punter now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. Yards on the punt with no return, and the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go.
Well, the defense got its job done, forcing the punt. Now the formula pretty simple. They need to find the end zone here. A field goal doesn't help them much.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
That's caught. It's Shai Smith.
And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. The drive starting with a 1st down, 11 yards on that pickup. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. Darnold now to throw. Flushed out, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
Boy, that's tough, Charles. First play of the drive, you're hoping to stay ahead of schedule. You take that huge sack, and now you're facing 2nd and a mile.
And the entire time, you were probably thinking the same thing I was. Either get rid of the ball, safely, of course, or go down. The yardage he gave up on that play, that's going to be tough for them to make up.
Throwing on 2nd and long. Darnold. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Rodney McLeod. And they will finally get to him, but a great return has set him up. 1st and goal at the 5.
With such a costly interception, nearly a pick 6, but now they're so close, they are knocking on the door for a touchdown.
And I never want to get on any team for being aggressive, because that's part of what their makeup is, and oftentimes it's successful. But in this case, you've got to be selective about it and make sure you...
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts.
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown.
Jalen Hurts with now two fourth quarter touchdowns.
And the Eagles might be headed to the win column for the first time this season as they add on to their lead. Elliott Good with a PAT. And the lead now up to 14. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game.
Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
Darnold. Throw left side complete to Isabella. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
That's a gain of 7. Brings up third and 3.
Finds the mic. Check.
Here's Darnold. Rolling to his right. He's going to let it fly. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year.
And the Panthers have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away.
From the 6.
And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And this game not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all 3 timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are.
And they'll run the option to start the drive.
A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28.
I know you're trying to wring every yard out of a run, but I think 9 yards there is ideal in this situation.
Yeah, now next couple plays, you only need 1 yard. Keep that clock rolling with a lead here in the fourth.
Yeah, what you're saying is maybe if it takes you 1 or 2 more runs to get the first down, that's extra time, extra plays. Really hurts the team on defense.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted.
Jeremy Chin picks it off.
And the return will stop right around the 25. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
And he'll have a first down, but a great tackle there keeps him from getting to the boundary.
Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. As they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Now Darnold.
That's to McCaffrey, complete. And he is across and in for the score. And now they can tie the game in the final stages with an extra point.
Or they can go for 2 and go for the win. And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down 1. That extra point is not a gimme.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we may very well be headed to overtime. Set to go now with with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter.
Let's take it in at the goal line.
And he's going to be taken down inside the 10 at about the 8-yard line.
Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And that won't help much. Only a yard on first down. And with inside of 10 seconds, 8 to be precise, we get whistles and a timeout on the field. They run with Sanders off the option. And he's got room. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he'll be taken down here, and that is how this one is going to come to an end. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
And we will not see a return to start overtime. It'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Eagles' offense set to begin their next drive. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still...
Oh, and it's intercepted! Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. A costly mistake here at OT.
And you know what they say when you throw an interception like that in overtime? You don't usually get a chance to throw a second one. I mean, I'm not sure the analytics on it. Let's ask Marvin, our statistician, to ring that down for us. That's typically how coaches and teams feel about it. If you throw one, you likely cost yourself the game.
57 yards rushing for him now as he is just trying to will his guys to an overtime victory. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And down inside the 15 he goes. They'll get 13 yards for the second quarter.
One of the more productive and durable players up until last year. Remember, in 2019, 116 catches, which was an all-time record for NFL running backs. Trying to come back from an injury-filled 2020, just 17 catches on the year. Sure is great to see him back on the field doing his thing.
Defensively, a solid response after giving up back-to-back first downs. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the player there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on 3rd down. Now Darnold going to take it and just bat this one forward to his wideout. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Well, that'll help the old passing stats. Remember, it was a pop pass, so it's not a wide receiver run there, Charles.
Well, I like the way that you scored it, and that's exactly how it goes into the books. But remember, he's had success throwing the ball the standard way in this game. And here, this little top pass, it goes for good yardage, a little something extra in his repertoire.
He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal. 2nd and goal from the 1. 2 minutes left in this overtime session, and still all tied. Another shot from the 1 on 2nd and goal. On the ground, McCaffrey. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. He lost two there, and it's third down. All right, well, they didn't kick it on second down, now third and goal. You have to kick it here.
Absolutely have to kick it, because if you get a bad snap, you fall on it, you got a chance to kick it again on fourth down. Let's say it gets blocked, and it's behind the line of scrimmage. You fall on it.
And this will be caught. Touchdown. They needed overtime to get it done, but put this one in the win column. So the game-winning touchdown came through the air in overtime. Four quarters wasn't enough. We were treated to a really good one, weren't we, Parker?
That we were, and I just love being able to be witness to a game like this all the way through. Who's going to win it? Oh, what? We're getting overtime? Great for us. A lot of tension on the field. Very tough. Not a surprise it ended with a passing touchdown. That's the way we play in the NFL. But the execution was pretty darn good.
Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on number. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claim me, you my none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.
Tables and turn. Forget the bridge we done built. It's time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring it
paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in.
Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. See him from the view. Got my check up. And now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud of shoot. And all designer drink it what I desire. Put him out. What I told him. Cause that boy he on fire.
Walk in that thing and air it up. And in my bag a little bit.
Remember my pockets in a jar. I couldn't build a little chick.
They say that Trini left his paper.
You see that's a miss. Why you catch all my brothers balling. Ain't shooting no bricks.
Hold up. Check me out.
Hold up.
I think the tables and turn.
Forget the bridge we done built. It's time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring it
paper, paper, paper from the first to the third.
They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in.
Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Oh,
they count me out.
Nah, nah.
It all begins.
Right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can. Never really care what they say.
On God.
Only ever care about one thing.
Ching, ching, ching.
Cha-chain, cha-chain. Rackets, rackets.
Hit the bank.
Ba-bang, ba-bang. Put you in your place. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
Nope.
Ma, he got it rocking. We bring havoc to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' copy cause we poppin'. Blues up in my wallet. If I like it, then I cop it.
Hold up, check me out.
I think the tables and turn. Forget the bridge we done built. It's time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I
bring it paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me